Hey, I'm Jim Tierney, president of Digital Anarchy, and in this tutorial, we're going to talk about using YouTube captions with Transcriptive. It's really easy, and YouTube has an extremely accurate speech-to-text algorithm. It's actually one of the best that we've seen. And the other bonus with YouTube is that it's free, so you can get your captions for free. It's great. Or you get your transcripts for free. There are some downsides to it. There's no punctuation, and because you're exporting as a VTT file, the lines are 32 characters long. So there is a little bit of cleanup that you need to do within Transcriptive. And also, it's slow. It's probably the slowest option out there. So if you have like an hour-long piece of footage, Speechmatics will get you the transcript back in about 15 minutes. YouTube, for an hour piece of footage, is probably about an hour to 2 hours to get that, to get the captions back. So there are some downsides to it, but it is extremely accurate, it's free, and now it works great with Transcriptive. You can just export captions out of YouTube with as a VTT file, and then import that right into Transcriptive. Every word will still have time code. It's a really cool solution. So let's take a look at what's involved. All right, so the first thing we're gonna have to do is encode the video. And you can see right now I'm in a sequence that already has the transcription. This was done with Speechmatics. So we can compare Speechmatics to YouTube. So we'll go to a sequence that has not been transcribed and come up here to load transcript. That will give us a new blank transcript here. And the next step is to export this out, or just click Command M or Control M, and that'll bring up our export dialog. Now the trick with this is all we're really doing is uploading this to YouTube, getting the captions, and then deleting it. In this case, we're just uploading it to get the transcript. One, we don't care about the quality of the video, and two, we want the file size to be as small as possible so that the upload time is as fast as possible. And now the thing you're going to notice is that we're going to change this, the resolution, to 640 by 480. That's the smallest resolution that YouTube will accept. We're going to set the quality very low, and we'll set the compression actually really high. If we're limiting the data rate to 500K, that's really going to crank the compression up, and it's really going to make for a small file. And again, we do that because we don't care about the quality of the video. We only care about the quality of the audio, and we want the file to upload as fast as possible. So now that we've set up the video correctly and set audio to uncompressed, and now we can click export, and Premiere will render that out. Once Premiere is done with that, we can jump over to YouTube, and we're going to select that file, select YT upload, and open. And YouTube is going to process this. It's going to upload it. It's going to process the video. We are not going to publish this. We do not want to make this public to the world. This is really only uploaded just for getting captions. And we're going to delete the file after that's done. So now it's processing. So that's done. And we're not going to fill out any of this other information. We don't really care about it. Again, we're going to delete this video. We're going to go to Video Manager. And we can either click on Edit or just go straight to Subtitles CC. And you can see that there is nothing here right now. We can add subtitles if we already have them, but if we want the automatic ones, we have to wait. And this can be a bit of a problem for longer video clips. It can take quite a while to process the captions. So if you have an hour-long clip, you know, it may take an hour or so for it to process. And then once it does, you'll have a English automatic button right here, and we can do that. Okay, so it took about 5 minutes to get back the transcript for this 40-second video here. And if we click on English automatic, we can see what the transcript looks like. And if you want, you can try and edit it in YouTube. But you'll find that it's much easier to edit in Transcriptive. And so we're gonna come to Actions and download the VTT file. And it's very important that you use VTT. Transcriptive will import other file types like SRT, but only with VTT will each word have the time code associated with it. So I'm gonna save this VTT file, and I'm going to import transcript. I'm gonna select the VTT importer, and browse to where this is. Say downloads, Serena VTT, and open that up and import it. And one of the most powerful things about Transcriptive is the fact that words all have time code. So if I click on Beauty Box here, it's gonna jump right to where that was set. And you won't get this functionality if you import an SRT. Only with VTT files does this happen. And that's all there is to it. And again, just to wrap it up, when you export the video out, you wanna make the video as small as possible, so the file size is super small, so that it uploads quickly, but keep the audio being very high quality. Then upload that to YouTube, wait for the captions to appear, and then download that VTT file. And once you do, then you have it in Transcriptive. This is all searchable. So if we're trying to find where she says Beauty Box, she says it here, we can jump to the next one. We can, of course, come in here and edit this. So we can start combining these together, adding punctuation if we want, and just going through and making whatever edits we need to make. And then you can export out as different types of caption files, simply XML files, SCC, MCC, lots of different formats that are supported by Transcriptive. So anyway, so that's a great way of getting free transcripts that are very accurate. We're very impressed by YouTube's speech-to-text algorithm, and it does a really nice job. It's just a little bit slow, so you will be waiting around for the transcript a lot longer than you would, say, if you use Speechmatics. But it is accurate, it is free, and that is the trade-off. So hopefully that was helpful. You can download a free trial of Transcriptive at digitalironkey.com, and you can see for yourself how it works and how accurate it is and how easy it is to edit your transcripts. So head on over to digitalironkey.com, and we will see you in the next tutorial.